COVID-19 is a new strain of coronavirus. Coronaviruses generally cause only common cold in humans. However, occasionally they have caused more severe disorders like the SARS outbreak of 2002, the MERS outbreak of 2012, or the current COVID-19 pandemic. So what do we know about coronavirus and COVID-19 specifically? Coronavirus is a RNA virus. It carries RNA as its genetic material. The RNA is complex with a nucleocapsid protein. This complex is surrounded by a lipid membrane. Spike proteins are found on the lipid membrane. Coronavirus derives its name from this crown-shaped spike proteins. Corona means crown in Latin. These spike proteins play a major role in infecting host cells. The spike proteins bind to ACE2 proteins on human cells to enter the cells. The spike protein consists of two connected halves. These two halves have to be separated before the virus can enter the host cell. In the SARS virus of 2002, the two halves didn't separate easily. However, in the new COVID-19 strain, the two halves are readily separated by the action of enzyme furin, which is abundantly present in human tissues. This makes the COVID-19 strain more infectious than the 2002 SARS virus. A recent study showed that the COVID-19 virus remains in aerosol for up to 3 hours, on copper for up to 4 hours, on cardboard for 1 day, and it remains on plastic and stainless steel for up to 2 to 3 days. As the virus is highly contagious and robust, it is important to follow the issued advisories. Person-to-person contact should be minimized. As the virus remains viable on surfaces for days, it is safer to stay home. The virus is surrounded by a lipid membrane. Surfactants in soaps dissolve the lipid coat, killing the virus. This is why washing hands with soap regularly and thoroughly is such an important weapon in combating the current pandemic. The mortality rate from COVID-19 is low, but the mortality rate is especially high in people above 65 years of age. However, every person has to be careful and responsible irrespective of their age, because if the number of cases overwhelms a country's health system, the mortality rate will rise. The same thing happened in Italy, and there are lessons to be learned from the sad example of Italy.